show 20 years ago. So all of the Mashpins are gone now from the NBS. So just to sort of address one of the concerns about the returning Filipino expat. So I just came back just a few months ago. And I just want to ask a very specific question before I get to the forum next. Because I understand a lot of what they're trying to say, but a lot of the conversations that I'm hearing here, it's all from the OSD, it's from the economic side, but I'm not hearing anything from the private sector. Yeah. And I don't know if you have any private sector actors here. So full disclosure, I'm also from the private sector. I was, after PIDS, I moved on to government. I moved on to DTI, DOI. I also eventually became a United Nations volunteer for corporate responsibility. I believe we have a UN volunteer here somewhere. I think that was, I saw that in the list. And over the last few years, I've moved on to becoming part of compliance and sustainability work. And one of the things that we kind of noticed is that when I'm looking at the study, I'm not really seeing a sectoral breakdown. Because when we start talking about where to put funds in for to support innovation, when you talk about other manufacturers, it's really rather broad. So I'm trying to figure out where this aligns with the manufacturing, the whole Philippine industry plan that was supposed to be launched last year. How does that then help what DTI is doing? Because as somebody who came from the private sector, when we start talking about innovation, we will not intrinsic or instinctively go to DOSD. We will go to DTI first. So that's why I agree with you wholeheartedly when we have to talk about a full government approach, because the assumption here is that ultimately all innovation comes from the customer. And I agree with you that 100%, because that's the lived experience that I've had over the last 20 years. If you're not in tune with the customer, whatever your programs are in academia, you have academic programs that don't align with what the industry looks for. And you're also stuck with department, with the government programs that are stuck on what was happening 20 years ago. My favorite is, so-and-so in sector is a sunset industry. And if you keep giving that kind of ammunition, then of course you won't invest because you're saying it's a sunset industry and you're not creating innovation around that area. Right? So going back to that, which sectors were actually included in the study? Which ones were growth industries? Which ones were sunset industries? And has that been aligned with what's actually